Good day, Minecraftians. Purple Mentat here, bringing you episode 37 of my Regrowth Let's Play. Last time, we made a couple of straw golems and investigated how to extract essentia from items using your alchemical furnace and alembics, and talked a lot about jarring things, the void jars, how to use the labels, make files, all of that. So you're going to need the knowledge from last episode for this one to make any sense at all. Today, we're going to be making some golem animation cores so that we can put our straw golems to work for us. And the best way to do, well, the only way to do that is going to be starting with the blank core itself, for which you need night ore. And night ore is one of those alchemy recipes, one of those alchemy researches that you need to move forward. So it is required to even get to essentia distillation. Night ore is made with ignis, lux, and potentia with a bit of glowstone. So I have myself here 3 files of ignis, 3 files of potentia, and 24 torches, which each have 1 lux. So I'm going to toss all of the torches in, and then we'll do a file at a time with a couple of glowstone to get some night ore back out. Careful use of your crucible will allow you to avoid polluting the environment. Once again. Anytime you make anything in Thaumcraft, by the way, make sure you scan it. You're going to want those research points, and you're going to want the extra special researches that these open up for you as well. Yeah. It can be important. Make sure you scan what you're making. So to actually make the golem animation cores, you're going to need to combine that night ore with 4 bricks apiece, as well as 5 ignis and 5 ordo. And that'll get your blank golem animation core. We can only get 4 made at the moment because we don't have enough V. But that's okay. We actually only need 2 at this time. Always scan. Scan everything. So to turn these golem animation cores into the typed ones that we want, in this case, harvest, we're going to need to combine them in the crucible with some essentia. Once again, to make the harvest core, we need 5 mesis and 5 mito, which is not that great, honestly, because it's hard to get 5, and it's hard to get a multiple of 5. A common multiple of 5 and 8. Your only real option is 40, and I don't know if I really want to make 8 harvest cores. So we're probably just going to be stuck with the idea that we have to waste some of the messes and some of the mito. Now, the real problem that we're going to run into is getting access to the harvest aspect of mito, because this stuff really doesn't show up on a lot. So far, I've found gold hose and sprinklers that contain it. Now, there is one other place that we can find it that might be a little less expensive. Let's find out with a bit of scanning. Put some iron together to make some shears, and if we scan these, they should have metallum and mito. Yeah, and that's 6 and 3. So we might... I think actually that melting down shears is going to be the direction that we want to go with this. So I'm going to need at least 10 mito if I really want to make best use of these. Let's go ahead and get myself 4 or 8 more iron here, so that I can make a total of 5 shears to melt down into mito. By the way, feel free to leave a comment below telling me a better source of mito, and I will do my best to remember to add it as an annotation to the video later. So if you see something pop up right now with a better source of mito, you'll know that someone else knew this better than I did and was able to offer a better solution than melting down shears. Mesis, on the other hand, is actually really simple to get. We've got a pile of wheat right here, and wheat contains 2 messes and 1 famis each. So I'm just going to go ahead and melt 32 wheat to get a full jar of messes. As soon as we have our shears done melting, we're going to need more jars, aren't we? Yeah. So let me go ahead and get the rest of this melted up and craft some more jars for myself. I'm going to need to make more glass. Yep, I'm going to do a little bit of work off camera to get this stuff ready, and I'll be back once we're ready to continue. All right, I decided to make extras. If you ever need to add a bunch of single non-stackable items in, your best bet's going to be a chest on a hopper feeding into one of the sides of the alchemical furnace, and it'll go ahead and keep things stocked. This will also be useful later when you want to be able to mass produce essentia for some other things. We'll get into that later. So let's go ahead and get our Golem animation cores made. We're gonna have to decide just how many we want to make. You know what? No. We're gonna go ahead and we're gonna make all five. We can do this. We can do this without wasting a darn thing. Why not? All I need to do is get the... Oh, I already have everything I need for the rest of the cores. I don't know if I'll ever use five harvest cores, but you know what? At least I'll have them. And then we'll put the other three into here for now. And we're going to grab our five messes that we got set up. And because I'm a little concerned about overflowing this, because 80 essentia is a lot to throw in at one time, we're going to go slow and just do kind of one at a time thing. Something's gone wrong. Right, I needed the other three. I forgot. It's not five, it's eight. I'm never going to use this many cores, but that's all right. There we are. Eight Golem animation cores, no wasted aspects. So I guess that's a good thing. We still got a bunch of Mito and, of course, a ton of Metallum left over. And we can take our labels back now. Ooh, hang on. You weren't done. You still have five Metallum in you. Let's wait for that to drain out into the warded jar. I mean, the void jar. There we are. And you, and you. Little difficult to hit the top of those all the time. All right, so let's go put one of these straw golems into effect. What we're going to do is we're going to have him stand. You know what? We're just going to set him right there. Maybe? There we go. Right-click him. He falls down. And he does nothing until we right-click him with the animation core. And then he runs around and he's going to go ahead and harvest all of the stuff that is within four blocks of him. Which means that he's popping off four coal essence at a time. Now, we already have something that is automatically grabbing up that coal essence, so we're not going to build anything else to do that. We're just going to let this guy go and create all of the coal essence for us, and it's going to get sucked into this chest by our friendly hopper hawk right here. Nice. Pretty happy about that. Speaking of the hopper hawk, he is drawing mana from one of these pools. I do have a plan for later to sort that out, but I kind of don't want to put it into effect yet because it involves some stuff that comes from a later version of Botania. Right now, what I'm doing is I'm just, when this mana pool fills up, I am then giving it the recessive augment. That's it. Sorry, brain fail. And then I'm letting it drain into these two. And then when it empties out, I take that recessive augment away and let this fill back up. And then we're going to need dominant augments for basically the other six over here if I want to keep all of these mana pools filled, which I do. As you can see, he goes into a bit of a cooldown slash sleep cycle and just hangs out over here. And then when he notices that things are available, he runs out and does more harvesting. Now, right now, I've got a couple of options. I could just come back here and collect the essence of coal myself periodically, turn it into actual coal, and then turn that coal into blocks of coal. But I don't want to do that because that's a fair bit of manual labor that I will have to do on the regular to make sure that my endoflames stay filled. Instead, we're going to investigate another option, and the first thing that I'm going to need to do for that is to make myself another B-Space Barrel to link into this network. I'm going to go get some materials together off screen, and we'll be right back. All right, to make some better automation happen for our little golem farmer, we are going to want to make ourselves another botanical device. First thing we need is a crafting table. We're actually going to want two of these. One of them we're going to combine with some living rock to make crafting placeholders. More on those in a moment. The other one we want to combine with dreamwood planks to create the crafty crate. And we're actually going to need a second crafty crate now that I think about it. So let me go ahead and grab one more dreamwood and get that made. Almost. Except I can't mouse today. There we go. Now, the crafting placeholder we're going to want to combine with 8 redstone. And in our full crafting grid. Here we go. So, this on the outside, this in the middle, and you'll notice that this creates a crafting pattern number 9, the donut. So, let me demonstrate how we're going to make this work for us. How do I want to do such? You know what? We're going to go ahead and just have things run up and to the left. That's what we're going to do. We are going to grab from our tools bag, our Buildcraft bag. And out of our Buildcraft bag is going to come the 1 emerald transport pipe, wooden engine. We're also going to need a lever in a moment. I'm going to want some gold transport pipes. Just a couple. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, that'll do. And we're going to want a couple of quartz transport pipes, and we're actually going to use up some diamond transport pipes. I believe we want 1 diamond transport pipe here. Okay. So if we put our emerald transport pipe there and our wooden engine there, and we're going to need to give that a redstone signal with a lever. Oh, I can't put a lever on the wooden water tank. Of course not. That would be far too easy. That's okay. I can put a lever right there. Okay, good. It did work. Excellent. So we're going to tell the emerald transport pipe in just a moment that it is allowed to pull out the essence of coal. And we're going to give this a quartz pipe, a diamond pipe, and another quartz pipe. And then we're going to put our crafty crate underneath like so. And we're going to tell the diamond pipe by right-clicking on it that it is allowed to send essence of coal down, and only essence of coal. The emerald transport pipe is going to go right there into the filters, so that we are currently whitelisting only the essence of coal in the emerald transport pipe. Now, this is going to start putting the essence of coal into our crafty crate. It fills the slots going across and then down. But if we throw the crafting pattern donut on there, now it will always be stuck so that it cannot fill the center area, which means that this is going to slowly produce coal for us. And once that gets up to speed, it'll pump things through quite a bit faster. Now, all we need to do is tell it to create the blocks of coal for us, which we're going to do by whitelisting the coal. And because the coal is the only other thing going into this pipe, it is going to be allowed to go past the first crafty crate. You know, though, it's probably never going to get to the coal at this rate. So we're going to fill in down here with the essence of coal so that the coal itself goes up first. We might need to power this. I don't know if that's something that still works, if we power this engine with something faster. Like, say, if we power this with a better engine, will it pull items out faster? I need to do some research on that. I was under the impression that the Emerald Transport Pipe would just flat pull more out without any outside intervention. But in any case, as you can see, this is now auto-crafting to coal for us. The very last thing to do is going to be to go grab that B-Space barrel and attach a barrel on the same B-Space system which I don't actually have ready. So let me get that ready. Back in a moment. Okay, so like before, we take a barrel, we add a structural upgrade. We need the Mark 1 upgrade first. I keep forgetting that barrels do that because I'm so used to playing with the drawers. Toss on the Mark 1 upgrade so we can put on the Mark 2 upgrade so we can get the B space. And in this case, we're going to need a storage. Oh, this is a sticker. That is not useful. I need a storage upgrade. Here we go. They look almost the same to me. So there we go. Now we have these upgraded, but I cannot resonate you with you. Oh, actually I can. It used to be you had to have this empty. Anyway, this is now a part of the same system. And if I grab a stack of coal blocks out of here, it comes out of there and out of here. We now have 3 points tied to the same storage space. I love B space barrels. So we're now going to grab the dolly and move this guy onto the chain. Let's take a look at how, whoops. I just wanted to take a look at how this is doing. Yeah, this one extraction pipe is definitely not keeping up. I think we need to find something better to power it or some other way to extract more faster. And that might mean more extraction pipes. It might mean something else altogether. I will investigate that momentarily. For now, though, what we're going to do is we're also going to, add the block of coal to that blacklist. And we're going to replace this quartz transport pipe, actually, with another diamond pipe to tell it to send coal down to black and blocks of coal to the left. Well, we actually don't need to tell it to send blocks of coal to the left. It'll do that for us. There we go. And then on black, we are going to put a single piece of coal. There we are. And now we can put the B-space barrel here. Anything that gets by should only be the blocks of coal. Put the quartz transport pipe there. And anything that does end up spilling out, the Hopper Hawk will go ahead and pick up for us. Fantastic. I'm pretty happy about this. Oh, last thing, we need to actually whitelist the blocks of coal. That's important. There we go. Unfortunately, as I said before, this is creating coal. Like, this one area with the sprinkler and the straw golem is creating things a lot faster than I can actually make use of them because the wooden engine is only pulling out a single item at a time. So we're going to look at a faster method of getting items from the chest into our pipe system. Back in a moment. All right, so the improved engines that would allow this to pipe out faster, I don't know if something like the hobbyist engine will work. We're going to attempt it, but the wiki calls for a Stirling engine to come from the Buildcraft mod itself. I'm not 100% certain if that hobbyist engine is going to serve as an adequate replacement, but we're going to do our best to find out. I can't pull water out of there. Can I pull it out of the cauldron? Yes. Excellent. That, I thought I could pull it out of the cauldron. That didn't work out at all. It actually deleted the extra buckets that I had. Okay, there we go. It just took a moment for them to show up in my inventory for reasons. Anyway, we're going to try tossing a hobbyist steam engine on this thing and see what happens. And we're going to go ahead and power up with coal because it's not like we don't have an overabundance of coal at this point. If this will work, then we can kind of do some trickiness to make this better. But it's on. It's burning. Once we get the power, the heat up to 100, we'll find out if it starts pumping out faster. This is our Hail Mary play. If this doesn't work, then we're pretty much sunk and we're going to have to reduce the amount of stuff that we're producing. And, oh, it's pumping. Oh, yeah, that just took out like 16 coal in one go. Excellent. There we go. So our hobbyist steam engine, especially once it gets up to full steam, is going to be able to crank this thing into the kind of production speed that we're going to need. Now, we are going to need to find a way to keep this thing fueled. And it would be entirely possible, actually, to... you know what? I think if I just adjust the way some things are positioned, we could absolutely run this piping over the hobbyist steam engine and have a diamond pipe say, hey, put in coal here, and then let everything else run to the rest of the system. But the problem is then it was going to dump coal in. We could use a clay pipe because then it'll only input coal if there's enough room for it. Yeah, we can do that. So we're going to take out this wooden engine because you are no longer necessary. You no longer have any useful effect. We're going to turn this off just long enough for me to rebuild the system a bit. We need to get rid of this plank right here because it's no longer serving its purpose. We can just set the lever over here. That'll do. And we're going to grab clay pipe was the idea. Insertion pipe prioritizes machines and chests over neighboring pipes. So we're going to have a run through a clay pipe before it runs up and over. And you know what? Yeah, we're going to have to. What we're going to do here. So there are a number of transport pipes that will not connect to each other. Quartz won't connect to cobblestone or stone. And where was it? Only connects to other pipes is the sandstone. We're going to want a stone pipe right here. We're going to put stone there and quartz underneath. Or actually, we're going to put stone underneath and quartz up there. There we go. And did my quartz pipe end up in here? No, but a lever and a redstone engine did. Or a wooden engine, depending on if your scripts are functioning or not. And where'd my clay pipe go? I mean, my quartz pipe. I guess I put it away for some reason. There we go. That makes for a decently compact pipe setup. Now let's start pumping. See how well it works. So we've got some coal blocks going through first. And they're skipping. Good. We're coming up on some coal. Hopefully. Oop. Rendering blip. That's annoying. Oh, there's the coal. Yep, it's going down. And some of it bounces back out and heads the other direction. The rest of it, all of the essence and everything, is just skipping it. Good. And from all appearances, every koosh sound there is 16 of something going through. So with any luck, this will actually be able to keep ahead of things, especially once it gets up to full steam. Now, we're going to need to make sure that this thing has water, which is actually really simple to do because we've got a pump down here already. We're going to just go ahead and hook it into the water line that's currently supplying our wooden water tank there. And, we're going to need to run it like that. Okay. We just have a basic quartz fluid pipe there. Okay, that's fine. That's all we need. Put away the gold transport, the clay transport, grab out some more quartz fluid pipes, and run them like so. And there we go. This will stay full of water. This will stay full of fuel. The temperature will cap out around 500 degrees. I don't believe it'll ever blow up. And hopefully once the steam gets full, which should happen eventually, I believe, if it runs long enough, it will produce more RF per tick, which should allow it to produce, send out even more items every pump than it's currently doing. Anyway, I'm going to let that run for a little bit and see what comes out of it. So I'll be back in maybe 10 minutes or so. Going to keep an eye on things and hope that it all works out. Huh. Some of the coal is being sent to the left. That's not okay. Shouldn't be doing that. Oh, there we go. Now it's speeding up. Yep, it's sending pulses of 16 more frequently. Unfortunately, it only grabs from whatever the first item in the area is, and the Hopper Hawk puts the small stuff up there first. But I think it'll be okay. I think it'll get through it all. Maybe I should put that redstone engine back after all. just to have the kind of belt and suspenders approach. Yeah. Yeah, I think I should. Soon as I find my leaf... Did I throw them all on the ground, or did I put them in my Buildcraft bag? Where the heck are my levers? I had like 20 of the thing. Oh, they're on my hotbar. The one place I was not looking for them. There. Alright, I'm going to watch this for a little bit and see how it does. Back soon. As you can see, now that the hobbyist steam engine is up to speed, it is keeping up with the system handily. So, now, as happy as I am with this, it still needs one further upgrade. So I broke down the barrel up here with an axe, which causes things to drop all of their upgrades all over the place. And we're going to set down the better barrel. We're going to add the copper, iron, and bronze structural upgrades to get your bronze ingots. You're going to want to go with the forestry ones, I think, are what's available. And you need to make molten bronze in your smeltery, but the alloy isn't showing up. Anyway, just 3 parts copper to 1 part tin gets you 4 parts bronze. So go ahead and make your bronze to get up to 7, and then you're going to need to reinstall your B-space upgrade. And we're going to want to create a new upgrade for this, which is the void upgrade. And this uses 2 more slots, and we're going to fill in the remaining 3. Oops. With the storage upgrades. So we're going to be applying 3 storage upgrades to each of our barrels. And the reason I want to have the void on there is I want to know that if I leave this system running, which I'm going to, it will not cause issues if I happen to run out of materials before, I mean, if I happen to run out of space before I start putting it elsewhere. I mean, it's already kind of raining materials onto the ground, which I'm not super happy about, but there's no other good way to really collect things right now than have items show up on the ground and the Hopper Hawk put them up, pick them up and put them into something. No, 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 no. You don't get coal. You get blocks of coal. Only blocks of coal. Hang on. We can make this happen. There we go. And now we can collect all of the coal blocks and get them in there. There we are. So now we just need to go through and upgrade the other 2 barrels the same way, and then get them all tuned to the same B space. And I am going to use the 3rd one. I don't particularly need the 3rd one right now, but it will be useful in the future. So let's get the coppers on, the irons on, the bronze on, and then void, void, B space, and 3 storage each. And now I just need to get everything tuned. Fork starts resonating. There we go. Barrels are resonating together. Fantastic. So now this will store up to 16,384 blocks of coal, and then it will go ahead and start voiding any extra after we hit the 16,000 mark. I'm not particularly worried about hitting the 16,000 mark, to be honest. I don't think that's going to happen anytime soon. By the way, you can use stickers to show the amount of coal that you, the amount that is in that block from any side. So I'm going to go ahead and sticker up my, barrels, because I think it's cool. There you go. Alright, I believe that that includes the automatic coal build. Fantastic. Now, we can start working on putting that coal to use and actually making use of our boiler. But of course, that's going to have to wait for next time. We are out of time. So, thank you very much for joining me, folks. I hope you have enjoyed this episode and this little build. It has been a long time in coming, and I am super happy to have it going. If you have enjoyed the episode, please leave me a thumbs up and tell me what you liked. If you have not, leave me a thumbs down, tell me what you think I can do better. Either way, you'll be interacting so that I will always continue showing up in your subscription feed. Why is this not working? You know what? That's what we're going to do. We're going to grab a coal block, and we're going to set that to crud. I'm going to need to get a Polycat in here. I can't tell what color that is, if it's green or yellow, and which one of these it belongs to. It looks like the lighter one, so I'm going to stick the coal block on there and wait and hope it keeps working. Seems to be. I don't know why these crates are having the issue they are. You know what, though? We can fix this. We can fix this before we go. One last thing. Before time out, we are going to go ahead and make ourselves another hopper. Maybe. If I can stop derping, that would be good. And like you. And we're going to use that hopper as what the... Oh, wow. Sorry about that. Super unprofessional. I forgot my phone was not on silent. All right. So the hopper is going to be what we actually input into. I'm going to need that thing back over here, which is the crafting pattern donut. Awesome. Now we do you and you. And we put the donut in there, and we have the hopper feed in here and here. And these are still set for coal essence out the bottom and coal out the bottom of that. Now I can put the coal in here, and it should feed in. Yep, it is feeding into the crafty crate relatively slowly, but it will no longer... It shouldn't have the issue where a bunch of coal ends up popping out. I hope. I don't know, this hopper might not be able to handle the speed that everything's moving at. And it doesn't seem... Oh, you know what? There's a redstone signal right there. Of course that hopper's not working. We should no longer need the wooden engine there anyway. There we go. Alright, and then that's just going to be a matter of, can this even manage? If not, then we're in serious amounts of trouble. But that's okay. I think things are pretty good. Okay. Yep, I'm happy with this. I hope you guys are happy with this build. I like it a lot. See you next time.